to let me shine. That's your way. You always walk a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strength. Without a name for so long, a beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything I would like to be. I can fly.
Of my mind, miss. shattered pictures of the smiles we left behind, smiles we gave to one another for the way we were.
Yeah.
Here we're getting ready for
a spooky
retirement party.
Where's Carol at?
Most of the people are here.
You like taking one behind?
I got a good shot of it.
Everybody's coming out, getting the banner out. Hurry up.
Hey, we want his name.
Here we have the banner. It says, "Happy Retirement, Spook." He's gonna shoot us, no doubt. Won't be long.
Yeah, he is.
He'll be here anytime.
John's narrating over here.
Someone let me in the pencil.
Here, Brian.
Here, Jordy. You gonna take a picture?
Here they come. And they're gonna Spook is gonna kill us.
Yeah.
Oh boy, is he gonna kill us? Gilbert. Here comes Gilbert.
Oh yeah.
Barry did.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Carla did?
Oh, Carla, I don't know.
Look out. You work together. Here, he's going to be turning the corner. He's going to kill us. Is he wearing a cap? He's gonna kill us.
Hey, the camera's off. It's not rolling.
Huh?
The tape's not rolling.
It's recording?
No.
Yeah, the red light on.
Gilbert!
That's good. We're going to have to get
my
in.
My camera's
it's too cold.
Yeah, it is. My camera is low.
That's enough.
Let's
go in.
Yeah.
John, over here, John. Quality right here.
Look what Uncle Brian is doing.
Yeah, she's starting to squirm, though.
Yeah, Uncle Brian should have to go change the next diaper, too.
I think it's a jingle. It's just squirming. You're going to have to take that much longer. I mean, that will work. Let me have it. Okay.
Thank you.
I'll pick him now.
I'm sure. The red light don't actually run his record.
We use half hour at a time, not more than 5 times a day. And it's issued to Gilbert E. Sheeter on November 24th, 1991. It's from the Couch Potato Committee.
Very cool. Oh, Karen.
No.
That's Karen
again. Bertie.
Karen.
Drum roll, please.
Hi!
Smile.
Oh, boy.
Mike. Hey, smile, Jenny.
Yeah, you gotta read that.
You want me to, Ferd? Okay.
Thanks a lot, Ferdy. Thank you.
It says, Gip, I hope that you have many years of happy retirement. You certainly deserve it after all the years at Indiana Death. I would also like to thank you for all the help you have given me over the years. You have always been a very good friend of mine, and you always will be. Thanks so much, and let me know if you ever need any help. Ferdy.
We're not done yet, Bob.
Okay, you guys have to kind of listen to this because otherwise it's not going to make any sense. But everybody knows how obsessed he is with winning the lottery, okay? So he's kind of been doing... he's been doing all kinds of stuff all the years and everything. And so he's always been a member to Reader's Digest, okay? And Carol has always had to fill everything out for him. And so, so far he hasn't won, but it says on here, you are one of our most faithful sweepstakes returners. Keep it up. Good luck.
$50,000.
$50,000. It's for the $1 million on the lotto cash, so you have to keep these just in case you need it. Now, is that what it is tonight?
You didn't figure it out.
And if that isn't enough, then we always have the Lotto America, and that's for 25
million. Oh, no, it's 45
million. 50 million. See, he knows them all.
They went up since they made out those cards.
I know it. But anyway, they're still hoping for all the rest of these, all these little nice games and stuff that are going on. So we're hoping. We can still probably hear that. And this one here, here we go. It's for the Hoosier Lottery for $1 million. And as you can see, we got express approval from Governor Ed Byer. Forgery. So, well, you know, there's always hope, and we're always hoping that this is going to work.
Hold that upside down picture. Be careful, don't scrunch it! Don't scrunch it!
Okay. So this is the for everything to start making Dad go to back to work again, right? To make all kinds of little
debts. Yeah. And all that. Well, it's not too bad anymore since you're gone.
Wait, I'll get you out there. I have plenty to do out there in Colorado. Thank you. Oh, yeah, big time. We just want to thank everybody for coming. And Dad, I guess everybody knows here at Dad in the factory for, 34 years? And our family has...
But my other brother Brian's not there.
We're gonna have to, when we get back to John James, we're all gonna have to take a picture, okay?
Come on out, you will melt.
Recording everything, Carol.
Last buzzer.
I have whenever I retire. They did that for me.
Yeah, he's coming out.
44 and a half years and one.
I have a pair of boots I'd like to.
I'm like, I know, I'm shaking. This is going to be a bad tape. You're going to take a picture, aren't you? Tape's gonna run out. This is gonna be a bad tape.
Hey, Tony!
I can't!
Hi!
Are you gonna kill us or what? Colorado.
Yeah, bail.
Over
Jordy, Papaw's gonna be coming out. Get out here.
The final buzzer. Come on, Dad.
Last buzzer he'll ever have.
No, I gotta work buzzer down there.
I won't have to see these people anymore. Yes, Dad. I feel, I mean... numb right now.
Quality.
together. Get all those people wary up there.
Yeah, Larry, tell them don't move. Everybody here. Yeah, he is.
Whoa, whoa. Come on, Gip.
You gotta wear the key hat.
Hey!
He goes by Nick!
How you doing, Gip?
Maybe I'll retire on the wall.
Yeah, you gotta retire a couple times, huh? Hi, Lucy.
Karen, did you get this at Farmore?
You know we did.
You know you went to Farmore.
Fine, how are you?
We got a little bit longer
here. There's Karen.
That's me.
Is that right?
Yeah, long as you're in the factory, now you can shoot.
I can't have any beer. Does Dan have it?
Joshy, say hi, Papa.
John, over here, John. Quality, right here.
Wow.
David Campbell.
Grouch.
And Phil and Ruth Hope. Thanks a million.
You're welcome.
Do it. Look at them, Shirley.
Do it.
Sit around, Dad.
That's from Ruth and Marty.
Yeah.
It says retirement. No worries, no boss, no phone, no time clock, no money. Who hollered that? Oh, that's the girl.
Remind me of my life.
I know, but I mean, is there a joke behind that? Oh, yeah, right.
I just got it. No, there's not a washroom going on there as well.
No more sugar.
Read that card.
No more sugar. No more sugar.
No more coke.
Oh, that's good.
More times. And try not to drive your wife crazy.
Try not to drive me crazy.
Pagan Leon Ma.
I got plenty. What do you got in there, Gip?
Yeah, okay.
Cookies
in a mug.
$50,000
for
this smell. Thanks a lot.
This
from the vessel. Thanks a lot.
I might be a lucky winner. Usually it was fun. You can only
hope. This from Larry and Mary and family. Thanks a lot.
Wait a minute, Papa. Here's Papa.
Had
the wrong one. Here you go, bud. Hi. Here's Papa. Yeah, I'm taking pictures.
It's from Patty and Jeff Summerson. Thanks a lot. Hey!
Come on. Josh, come
here. Negative. Look ahead.
Yeah.
This is from the burgers.
They're not here.
Hi, Dad.
Hey!
Nina, man, a papo.
Are you coming? Okay. I got your picture. Okay. That's my papa.
Thanks a lot.
My papa.
Would you move?
Let's get the heck out of my way.
Nice to your uncle.
Papa took your picture, okay? Yeah. You were with Uncle Gip.
John, Uncle Gip. We need for you to come over here for a second. We thought that these gifts here would be for both of these, so we want them both to open them at the same time, but then you have to, you know, show up to everybody.
Yeah, Carol, come here.
What does it say? Turn around.
It says this is not a bald spot, it's a solar panel for brain power.
Yes.
I was thinking.
Make it longer. Make it longer.
Let me sneak through the underground.
It's working.
Okay.
This is, it says, a recliner parking permit. It's to be used half hour at a time, not more than 5 times a day. And it's issued to Gilbert E. Sheeter on November 24th, 1991. It's from the Couch Potato Committee.
The last one I'll open up.
He kept that next to his heart.
Probably from Karen.
No.
That from Karen Gip.
Purdy.
Hi.
Drum roll, please.
Hi.
Oh boy.
Why?
Hey, smile.
Yeah, you gotta read that.
You want me to, Ferg? Okay.
Thanks a lot, Ferdy. Appreciate it.
It says, Gip, I hope that you have many years of happy retirement. You certainly deserve it after all the years at Indiana Desk. I would also like to thank you for all the help you have given me over the years. You have always been a very good friend of mine, and you always will be. Thanks so much, and let me know if you ever need any help. Ferdy. Okay, you guys have to kind of listen to this because otherwise it's not going to make any sense, but everybody knows how obsessed he is with winning the lottery, okay? So he's kind of been doing all kinds of stuff all the years and everything, and so he's always been a member to Reader's Digest, okay? And Carol has always had to fill everything out for him, and so far he hasn't won, but it says on here, you are one of our most faithful sweepstakes returners. Keep it up. Good luck. That's for $50,000.
$50 million.
What do you think?
We got him on order.
Okay.
I don't know.
Well, I don't play the lottery, so I don't know what's going on here. But the next one is for the Lotto Cash, which I'm sure Dad knows about that one too. It's for the $1 million on the Lotto Cash, so you have to keep these just in case you win it. Now, is that what it is tonight?
Get them fingers right.
And if that isn't enough, then we always have the Lotto America, and that's for $25 million.
Oh, no,
okay. $45 million.
$50 million. See, he knows them all.
They went up since they made out those cards.
But anyway, there's still hope for all the rest of these, all these little nice games and stuff that are going on, so we're hoping there's still hope. Oh yeah, we'll get to that. And so we can still probably and this one here we go. It's for the what is this Hoosier lottery for $1 million, and as you can see, we got express approval from Governor Evan Bayh here. So, well, you know, there's always hope, and we're always hoping that this is going to work.
Hey, Carol, one day you'll hold that up so I can get a picture of
it.
Be careful, don't scratch it! Don't scratch it!
I'll take that off.
Okay.
So this is the okay. But the main thing now, that's what Dad's been doing since he's at home all the time, is he sits by the radio and listens to the cash call.
Cash call.
And he carries it around everywhere he goes. We have one more thing. John, you need help? He got somebody.
That's too heavy today. Just give him them and he'll understand. Tell him.
Hopefully you can figure out what this all goes for. It's sitting over there.
Well,
the room.
Sitting over there, Pop, is your Sears 12-inch bandsaw.
Oh. I think you guys all have about everything to start making Dad go to back to work again, right? To make all kinds of little desks.
Yeah, knickknacks.
Well, it's not too bad anymore since you're gone.
Just wait, I'll get you out there. I have plenty to do out there in Colorado. Thank you. Oh yeah, big time. We could have used it about a month ago. We had an apartment down there, but we just want to thank everybody for coming. And Dad, I guess everybody knows he was down at the factory for what, 23 and a half years, 24 years. And our family has been through a lot of different stuff in the last 35 years. Sorry, that's how old I am. But we're just real proud of Dad and what he's accomplished over the years and stuff. And also to Mom for putting up with all of her six kids and everything that's going on. So we just want to thank everybody for coming and appreciate all the gifts and stuff too. Thanks.
Thank you.